Hey, and welcome to this tutorial about how to use Windows VST plugins on Linux. So maybe you have some plugins that you've used in Windows and you really want to use them on Linux and don't know how to do it. In this video, I want to show you how to do it. So it's important that you already have prepared your Linux for audio production use. Please watch my video about it. So I have installed and opened up Kala. You can find Kala in the KXStudio repositories. So Kala is a plugin host. You can run your native Linux plugins here, but Kala can also launch Windows VST plugins. So when we click Add Plugin here, we can see here my native Linux plugins that I have installed. When we click Refresh, we can see here that Kala Discovery is only searching for the native plugins. And we can see here that Kala Discovery Win32 and Kala Discovery Win64 are not available. So we have to install these packages. I install these packages with the terminal, but you can also use your software center. So in the terminal, we type sudo apt install kala bridge and then one with Win32 and then again kala bridge Win and then 64. And then we hit enter. We type in the password and hit enter. And then type Y and enter again. Now it's installing. So now it has finished installing. We can see here that we have WineRT installed now. This is a very important package. With Wine you can run Windows programs and the RT version comes with real-time processing. So let's launch Kala again. When we click Add Plugin again and refresh, we can now see that there are two new tools available here, and we click here and here to enable them. But before we hit start, we have to first install the plugins we want to use. So I've opened up the browser, and I now want to install the MiniFilter V from Arturia, which is only available at Windows and Mac, and I now want to use it on Linux. So I click Get Free Demo to download it. You have to then fill in this formula to get the demo. So with the download, you get this file here. We right click here and open up a terminal. Then we type Wine and then MiniFilter. And then we hit enter. It's now configuring Wine. Just hit install here. So when it's done configuring, you can see the setup of MiniFilter V here. You click I accept the agreement, next, 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 and install. So I'm now in the .wine directory. It's in your home folder. Here we have the drive C folder. We double click on it, and here we have to find the plugin files. There are different files in different locations. It's also different between the plugins. So your plugin maybe has installed the files into a different location. So normally the 32-bit versions are here, and the 64-bit versions are here. With the MiniFilter V, only the 32-bit version is running correctly. So we click here. And then VST plugins. And here we have the file. We copy it, then we paste it. We paste it to the .vst folder. You may have to create it first. It's also in your home directory. Now we go back to Kala again. In Kala we can now search for the plugin. We click start and then close. And then search for MiniFilter. And here we have it. We click on it and then add plugin. And here it is. We click here to open the user interface. And click demo here. So here it is, the MiniFilter V. Let's try how it works. So I've opened up Traction here, and here we have a little drum loop, and I'm now going to put this through the MiniFilter V. So we click on Patch Bay here, and here we can see our Patch Bay. And here's the MiniFilter. And here with choose check is traction. We go out here and to the input here, connect this to here that you can hear something, and to the system playback. So on traction, we start a loop. And we click rec and open up the mini filter. So, as you can hear, it's now filtering it. Okay, let's close this again and stop it here. So as you can see, it works, but not all Windows plugins run that smooth. Some don't run at all. I suggest that you try the demo first, if you are able to get it work on Linux. Maybe you are also getting a lot of X1s, then you should choose a higher buffer. So thanks for watching this tutorial. Please let me know in the comments if you want me to try different Windows VST plugins, and also if you have tried your Windows plugins and you got them to work or not. So please leave a like on the video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.